Kevin Lynch is on a mission to end the social stigma of mental illness. Lynch, a veteran of the U.S. Naval Submarine Force and hospital system professional, was diagnosed with clinical depression in 2012. But depression met its match in Lynch, who decided to battle the disease with knowledge, transparency, and grit. Lynch earned a master's degree in health administration at Penn State through our program on the World Campus. Researching his graduate thesis, Lynch recognized the devastating impact of a shortage and lack of access to mental health professionals. This insight was the trigger for Kevin Lynch to start the Quell Foundation, which in just 2 years will have raised nearly $2 million in donations and formed partnerships with leading academic institutions, including Penn State. The Quell Foundation provides scholarships to students entering the mental health care field and students who've been diagnosed with a mental illness. It also educates communities to reduce suicide, drug overdoses, and incarceration of people with treatable mental illnesses, and trains first responders to recognize signs of mental illness. Welcome back to Penn State.
Well, congratulations, you've done it. I remember that feeling of euphoria that I had when I was sitting in those very seats not too long ago. And to be honest with you, I'm sure that we had a fantastic speaker, but I don't recall a lot about that commencement speech. You see, I only have 10 minutes to make an impression on you. So I'm hoping that my life story changes your life story and the impact that you have on this world. So a bit about me. In 2012, when many of you are finishing up your junior and senior year of high school, my 26-year-old son was being released from a maximum security prison after having spent 8 years there. Six of those years, he was held in isolation for behaviors consistent with somebody that has a mental health diagnosis. Nick had bipolar disorder. When Nick was released, he thought he was too old to go to college, so I agreed that I would do it with him. He, his undergrad, and me, my graduate degree at 49 years old. But unfortunately, just 2 weeks before we were to begin classes, my son was found with a heroin needle in his arm. And while he did not die, he did return to prison. And I went somewhere much worse. I went to those deep, dark, and often debilitating depths of depression. So many of you may know this, but depression is the world's number one most widespread illness. And apparently, it doesn't discriminate. It doesn't care if you're Lady Gaga or Demi Lovato. It doesn't care if you're Prince Harry. So we know it doesn't care if you're Kevin Lynch. See, I always thought that mental health happened to somebody else. That's not the case. But today's not about me, it's about you. So I'm going to turn the tables and I'm going to ask you, all of you here today, some very personal questions, and I'd like you to give some thought to them. How many of you know somebody that lives with a mental illness? PTSD, depression, anxiety, bipolar disorder, maybe on the autism spectrum, or schizophrenia. Maybe it's you. You see, Penn Staters aren't exempt. In fact, your counseling and psychological services center here on campus have facilitated over 80,000 appointments since you walked on campus as freshmen. 80,000. I stand up here on behalf of 49 million Americans with an unwelcomed and unsolicited mental health diagnosis. And in a few moments, I'm going to ask you, all of you, to do something that's never been done before. But more about that in a moment. This is a happy day, and it's a day of celebration. And I assure you that I am not here to depress you, but I am here to deliver a message of hope and a call to action. Because I personally know that there is light at the end of every dark tunnel. So let me tell you why I am confident that this class, your generation, is going to remove the stigma on mental health. Why you are going to find that light that leads to brighter tomorrows for millions among us. Long before you ever got to Happy Valley, you had already begun to epitomize the first of Penn State's four principles, to respect the dignity of all individuals. Even at that young age, you decided to tackle one of society's and childhood's most significant issues. Your generation brought inclusiveness to the LGBTQ community. You supported their right to equality, and you made it socially unacceptable to voice a negative opinion about our LGBTQ family and friends. But let's make sure all of your family and friends know what you've done here at Penn State. The class of 2017, instead of leaving a physical memorial, you instead chose to permanently fund the Lions Food Pantry so that your fellow Penn Staters could receive free food whenever they needed it, with no questions asked. In the last 4 years, your class has raised nearly $50 million, $50 million to fight childhood cancer through THON. You see why I'm confident? You have grown up standing up for what was right. You have already done so much for inclusion and equality. You are the generation that has made a measurable and a meaningful impact on the lives of so many people. And for that, I applaud you. We all applaud you. Penn State has prepared you to think beyond geography, beyond limitations. You are the next generation of global citizens that is not only prepared to navigate change, but to make change happen, to reject the status quo, and to see obstacles as opportunities. When you leave Penn State today, you're leaving to a world who is awaiting your arrival, to a world that needs you now more than ever before. So I encourage each one of you to think much bigger, to think much bolder, personally, professionally, and always. Allow me to remind you of what our youngest ever Nobel Peace Prize laureate once said. Don't wait for somebody to come and speak for you. It is you who can change the world. That profound statement was spoken by Malala Yousafzai, herself a Gen Z, who at the age of 14 years old survived a Taliban assassination attempt on her life for her work advocating for human rights. I encourage you to tackle the world's most prevalent disease, to stand up and remove the stigma of mental health within your families, your communities, your work, and your social groups. I'm not asking you to make this your life's mission, but I am asking you to make it a priority, because we all know that even the smallest of gestures can have the largest of impacts. If you personally live with a challenge, whether mental or physical, refuse to succumb to the stigma. I ask you to embrace and support and encourage those closest to you who live daily with the challenges that come with having a diagnosed mental illness. At the beginning of this speech, I asked you some personal and thought-provoking questions. I asked you to think about those people in your life closest to you who may live with a mental health illness or perhaps lost their life to one. What can you do? How can you help? Allow me to share just one final story with you. Several years ago, I participated in a six-day, 400-mile bicycle ride from West Point Military Academy down to Annapolis, Maryland, the Naval Academy. I was with 205 other veterans, each one of them with some form of mental or physical disability. Many had both, but they were heroes. They were strong, they were fighters, and they were hurting. On day three, I happened to be riding next to a person I would consider likely the toughest Marine that I've ever met. Her name was Sylvie. I shared a bit about my story with Sylvie and my son. And I said, you know, some days it's really difficult for me to see the light at the end of the tunnel. And her reply, give me a call. I'll come sit with you in the dark. I'm going to ask you to do one final thing before you become Penn State alumni. In fact, I'm going to ask all of you to do something that has never been done on any college campus anywhere in this country. I invite all of our honored guests, all of our HHD faculty and administrators, your family and friends to join you in accepting this one final challenge to once again do the right thing. If you had a friend, a relative, or a loved one that could not see the light at the end of the tunnel, would you go sit with them in the dark? If you knew somebody was struggling, would you stand up and stand beside them so that they could feel your support and your presence? If your answer is yes to either of these questions, I'm asking you all to stand up right now. Right here, right now. We have cameras to document this historic moment. That Penn State stands up to mental health, that we refuse to allow depression, anxiety, or bipolar disorder, or any mental illness define us or those who we care about. We will show this country that when Penn Staters do something, we are all in. I would like this graduating class to take a look around you. This is why I know you are going to make a huge difference in this world, because you took the lead and you now have thousands of people in this auditorium standing up with you, supporting you, and encouraging you to go out and make a difference. May great things lie ahead for you and your great generation. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kevin.